Hi students, this is Dr. M.S. Pawar. Today we are going to learn the use of vernier caliper to determine the dimensions of the given object, or rather to measure the dimensions of the given object. Now this is the simple object given to you. Now it has three dimensions: outer diameter, inner diameter, as well as height, or I can say the depth of the hole. Now this we can find out using this instrument. Now this instrument is known as vernier caliper. Now we can find out the dimensions of this object using simple normal scale also. But if I use vernier caliper, the accuracy will be at higher level. I mean the same dimension I can find out more accurately using this vernier caliper. Now this is vernier caliper. See the parts of this. These are the lower two jaws. These are the upper two jaws. Here there is a locking screw. Here there is a main scale. At the bottom side of this window, here there is a vernier scale. Now how to find out the dimensions? To find outer diameter, use lower two jaws. Now how to record the reading? That I will explain afterwards. To find out the internal diameter, use upper two jaws. Hold the jaw like this. Put it inside this, spread it like this, and now I can take the reading. And to find the depth of this hole, I can use this strip. Put it inside this and I can find out the depth. Now the most important is how to record the reading, how to measure the reading. For that, come here. Now this sample reading. This is the outer diameter, this is the jaw which is hold between the two jaws. Okay, we are going to refer this particular table. The object is hollow cylinder or pipe. What dimension we are going to measure? Outer diameter. Now this is my sample reading. Now this is the main scale. The scale which is written in the red color is the main scale. And this is the vernier scale. Now observe this main scale very carefully. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 centimeter. In between 0 and 1 centimeter, there are 10 divisions. It simply means that 1 centimeter is equally divided into 10 parts. Therefore, cost of 1 division is 1 divided by 10, that is 0.1 centimeter. Now, it is very easy to read this 0, 0.1 centimeter, 0.2 centimeter, 0.3 centimeter, and so on. Now, this simple main scale, which is same as the normal scale. And on the vernier, if you go on counting, you will find there are 10 divisions. Okay. Now, how to record the reading? Now, this is the position, take the reading. Now, first column is main scale reading. First column is main scale reading. Now, for this, give your full attention on the zero of vernier. On the zero of vernier. And see the corresponding completed reading by it on the main scale. In my case, the zero of the vernier is lying between 1.2 and 1.3. The zero of the vernier is lying between 1.2 and 1.3. Now, which is completed? 1.2 is completed. 1.3 is not yet completed. Therefore, my completed main scale reading, I will write 1.2 centimeter. Now, this is my first part. Second part, note down the coinciding vernier scale division number. Now for this, you observe this 10 divisions very carefully. These 10 divisions and upper divisions, that is yellow and red, you will find they are mismatching. But out of this 10, there will be one such a division which will exactly coincide with one of the divisions from the main scale. Now go on observing. This is not coinciding. No. Now, this particular division is exactly matching with the above division. This yellow and red are exactly matching. Now this is my seventh division. Therefore, write only 7. It's a pure number. Next column. 7 into least count. Now least count of this instrument is 0.01 centimeter. What do you mean by least count? The least count means the smallest possible reading that we can measure using the given instrument. Now how it is determined? Very simple. The smallest division of the main scale is 0.1 centimeter divided by 10 gives me 0.01 centimeter. This is the least count of this instrument. Now come back. This is my coinciding division into least count, that is 7 into 0.01 gives me 0.07 centimeter. Now this reading added to main scale, that's all. This plus this gives me 1.27 centimeter. This is the outer diameter of the given object. Now simple technique, coinciding into least count, add that amount to main scale. That is the way of taking the reading. Now for more clarity, we will take one more example. Now imagine I have taken some other object and the dimension of that object I have written here. This is the sample reading shown in the diagram. Okay. Now first column is main scale reading, which is very important. You take it very carefully. Now observe this zero of the vernier and see the corresponding completed reading by term of main scale. Now in my case, the zero of the vernier is lying between 3 and 2.9. I repeat, 3 and 2.9. Therefore, my completed main scale reading is 2.9 centimeter. Second part, coinciding vernier scale division number. Observe this 10 divisions very carefully. Out of this 10, one will coincide with one of the division. Now this division is not matching with above. No, no, no. But this division is matching. This division exactly coincides with the above main scale division. Now this is my 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth division. Write down 4. 4 into this term and 4 into 0.01 gives me 0.04 centimeter. Add this 2. That is 2.94 centimeter is the diameter or the dimension of the given object. Right? In this way, we can find out the dimension of any object. Now suppose I want to find out the inner diameter. I told you like this, you hold the jaw using the upper two jaws like this. Now the holding style is different, the jaws are different, but the way of taking reading is same. The same process you have to follow. Okay. In this way, we can find out the dimensions of a given object very accurately using vernier caliper. Thank you. Thank you very much.